Damn, he about ate that deer's face off. Look at that.
Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon?
Learn something new every day.
All right. Where? Maybe in one of these.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? No, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me. It acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, D. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid. Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
you're a researcher. What the hell are they doing out here? Gotta go check them out, see what they're doing. All right, gotta go quiet. Something. If they see me, I'm dead. Throw a rock, that ought to distract them.
You doing all right?
Stay in the shrubs, they can't see me in there.
Got everything you need.
How are you feeling?
Stay low, stay low.
What the hell are we doing out here anyway?
What you told? A ship.
Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location.
What was that? Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Oh, shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Can't you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
They're sleeping like babies. And I asked if you were going in.
Can't be.
Didn't say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like it was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. But not them.
Shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was foobar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
Think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population?
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Sealed caves. Yeah, right, like anyone gives a damn.
Easy peasy.
We're going out! Load up! Load up! Go! Go! Go!
Harry Kern. Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back. We wrote on a fan. Hero. Soldier. Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. He wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
He's alive, loser. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
Now, I know that. Look, they went into their LZ.
Wait. Went into their LZ.
Listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... get some sleep. Deacon out. Cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving because if anyone had found your unmarked van. Thank you.
just like that, I'm out of ammo. It's all right. Damn freaks. This is what I've been trying to get over here.
this infestation zone later.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Black helicopters have been spotted in the skies. You might have seen them. Heard them. Thought you were losing your mind.
I need to find gas. Soon.
And proof that I was right. We thought Nero died out here like the rest of them, caving under their own stupidity. But no. Like I said, they've been lying and waiting all this time to crawl up out of their holes and reclaim this world. But it ain't happening. Not on my watch. Running towards them, thinking they're gonna save your ass. Any man wearing a uniform worth a damn died more than 2 years ago. These men, they shoot you on sight. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Jesus. Cope, they're not trying to reclaim shit.
You don't have a damn clue what you're talking about. Except, yeah, they will shoot you on sight. Lucky guy.
And I'm out of gas. Oh, I should stop back there. Let's see. I'll get through this tunnel, see if we can find some gas. I'm not gonna stop and look at all these trucks right now. So I got plenty of scrap.
site. I wonder if there's anything inside that mobile medical unit.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. This earth is a gift for us all. To use as we see fit. To provide for ourselves and our families. I'm not saying this.
That's it.
It's the Lord that gave us dominion over it. But that wasn't enough for some men.
Oh, God damn it. Fuse blown.
When our fuel got low, they jacked up the prices so they could consolidate power into their own hands. So, they wanted to build dams for electricity. But their precious runs of salmon were more important than heating our homes. We wanted to cut a few trees to build those homes. But the nests of a few spotted owls were more important than the entire timber industry. Now that the feds have gone to ground, let's just say we've eliminated the middleman. No one can stop us from taking what's rightfully ours. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Thing is, Cope, fuel prices have come down lately. Way down. Only problem is you gotta find it yourself. And last I checked, there were plenty of assholes out here trying to take what's rightfully ours. No, no, it's back that way. Here we go. Feels, yes.
I think that's all the,
I'll let you do it.
Speakers? I guess we'll find out.
Oh, yes.
Yep, that's all the speakers.
Here we go. Neuro injector. Just what the doctor ordered.
So, this time I'm gonna go with more focus. I have a system. Focus and stamina before health.
Do the trick. Micro recorder. Let's see.
Let go, man! God damn it, I said let go, ma'am!
Good.
You must return to your vehicle. We will get to you. For 12 hours, I've got 2 sick children in the back. We need... water. We just need a little bit of water.
Ma'am, you must return to your vehicle. Now, Eddie, you got some bottled water.
Give it to her. Oh, we got less.
Give it to her.
Thank you.
Okay. Go back to your vehicle.
Yes.
Letting more through very soon.
Okay.
Please.
Thank you. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
What? They're not letting anyone else through. The refugee camp's full.
What are we gonna do?
I don't know about you, but I got a plan.
Plan? What are you talking about? I don't understand.
No! No, no, no!
Oh, Jesus Christ. So many people. It's like Boozer said. Hell of a way to go. Backed up at this checkpoint.
chance.